Hi, my name is Ravneet and I'm a PhD student working with Dr. Nathan Boyd in Weed Science Lab at University of Florida Gulf Coast Research and Education Center, BOM. Vegetables in Florida are predominantly grown in plasticulture system. Typical field setup includes cultivation, bed shaping, fumigation, drip tape installation, and plastic installation. All these practices are very labor-intensive and expensive. Despite the high cost, usually one crop is grown on these plastic-covered beds. As a result, the input costs are really high and reliance on single crops becomes risky due to volatile market prices and competition from the foreign markets. The potential solution to all these challenges is to grow more than single crop on these beds. That is known as multiple cropping. Multiple cropping could actually increase the economic benefits of growers. It also leads to crop diversification, which reduces the risk of crop failure. To establish the multiple cropping system in Florida, we are doing some studies related to intercropping and relay cropping of tomatoes and bell peppers. There are three experimental setups in the field where we are optimizing the planting date and cropping density of tomatoes and bell peppers. First experiment is where our bell peppers are planted as main crop and tomatoes are planted as a secondary crop at three different planting dates. Second experiment is where our tomatoes are planted as a main crop and bell peppers are planted as secondary crops at different planting dates. The third experiment is where we have planted the tomatoes and bell peppers at different cropping densities, where we have different spacings. The standard spacing for tomatoes is 24 inches and other treatment is where we planted tomatoes at 12 inches. For bell peppers, the standard spacing is 15 inches and the other treatment is 7.5 inches.
So results from these experiments shows that intercropping of tomatoes and bell peppers could be a beneficial practice for Florida vegetable growers. Also, relay cropping of tomatoes within 30 days of bell pepper planting is also a recommended practice to manage the workload of growers properly. So it is important to note here that when relay cropping, the bell peppers should be planted as a main crop and tomatoes should be planted as a secondary crop. On the other hand, the increase in planting density of two crops when intercropped together is not recommended practice in case of tomatoes and bell peppers. The reason for that is the increase in planting density increases the competition between two plants and also reduces the yield of both the crops. Hope you like this video. If you have any questions, please comment below. Thank you.